dropping a nuclear bomb inside a hurricane.
Drop a nuclear bomb on them.
The president suggested bombing a hurricane on multiple occasions. Briefers reportedly told the president, quote, "We'll look into that."
Believe it or not, President Donald Trump isn't the first person to suggest we nuke a hurricane. Back in the 50s, a meteorologist named Jack Reed introduced the idea as a way to prevent hurricanes from reaching the coast.
High and low pressure areas are recorded hourly at each station.
And people have been asking why we don't nuke hurricanes ever since. In fact, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration has been asked this question so much, it has a webpage dedicated to answering just that.
So if you set off a nuclear weapon in a hurricane, not only will you still have a hurricane, now you have a radioactive hurricane. So that's not a positive development.
For perspective, a hurricane can generate the same amount of energy throughout its lifetime as 10,000 nuclear bombs. And the physical size of a hurricane is a major issue as well. Hurricane Irma measured 420 miles across. That's 70 times as large as the blast zone for Little Boy, the nuclear bomb dropped over Hiroshima. So detonating an atomic bomb inside a hurricane is sort of like poking a rhino with a stick and expecting it to just get out of your way. It's not gonna happen. Oh, and then there's the issue of highly radioactive nuclear fallout.
Best case scenario is that it rains out very quickly. And so the area that you've set the weapon off becomes highly radioactive and contaminated. That's your best case scenario. A more worst case scenario is, what if that somehow stays in the hurricane and moves as the hurricane, say, makes landfall?
In a worst case scenario, winds from the hurricane would quickly distribute the radiation throughout the entire storm, basically turning it from a massive storm with wind and rain into a massive storm with radioactive wind and rain. That's 10 times larger and millions of times more powerful than any nuclear bomb in history. Not to mention, hurricanes move fast. In 2012, Hurricane Sandy traveled over 2,000 miles from the Caribbean Sea up the U.S. East Coast in just 10 days. And we know from past experience what nuclear fallout does to an ocean and people nearby.
In 1954, the United States set off a very large thermonuclear weapon in the Marshall Islands, and it contaminated a lot of fish in the area. Japan ended up having a moratorium on fish consumption for some time as a result of this. And you could detect the radioactivity in fish for thousands of miles.
Plus, scientists estimated that 55% of all cancers in those living closest to the bomb site might be attributed to the bomb's nuclear fallout. So if we had nuked, say, Hurricane Sandy, not only would there have been the $65 billion in damage repair, but who knows how much more it would have cost in the additional damage to fishing industries, healthcare, and even the simplest things you might not think about.
Because you can't just rebuild the house, now you've also got to remove, you know, several inches of topsoil and destroy the original material and rebuild it from scratch if you want people to be able to live there without increasing the cancer rates.
Suffice it to say, nuking a hurricane, as Noah puts it, is not a good idea.
It's less of a sort of doomsday scenario as it is just a, like, really bad idea, no benefit scenario.